WGN investigates on Chicago's South Side. A dispute between a business owner and a powerful alderman is shining light on the much-maligned practice of aldermanic privilege and how city council members wield the power in their wards.
WGN's Mike Lowe is joining us with a closer look at how the process is playing out in one ward. Mike.
Lourdes and Joe, good evening to both of you. This is a story involving money and conflicting visions about what makes a business desirable and ultimately about the power of the permitting process.
The car wash services is to clean the cars.
Philip DiGerardo knows about dirt and grime.
This is my life.
The 57-year-old owner of the Buddy Bear car wash chain has been doing it for 3 decades.
My only business is car wash. I don't know anything else.
He says the car wash business, however, did not prepare him for what he calls the dirty business of Chicago politics, and says he's a victim of the misuse of the much-criticized practice of aldermanic privilege.
I think this is a clear example of abuse of the alderman's privilege, because he's not trying to block something that would affect the community, you know, negatively, like maybe a liquor store or a nightclub. This is a professional business.
He claims he's being zoned out of business after sinking nearly $1 million into this vacant land.
That next door to me is a machine shop.
In Canaryville on Chicago's south side.
This land at 46 and Halstead, this is a site that's been vacant over 20 years. I looked at this site because it was zoned, allowing a car wash.
And he also says he discussed his plans with 11th Ward Alderman Patrick Thompson.
I met with him late last year, and like I said, he wasn't for or against.
He was noncommittal?
Noncommittal. And a month later, his office left a message that to my realtor, he didn't call me, their office left a message with my realtor that they were not in favor of a car wash.
DiGerardo completed the land purchase in May. The alderman proposed changing the zoning on the property 1 month before, in April.
It's the commercial spine of our ward.
Thompson says a car wash wouldn't fit with the overall development plan for the corridor, which calls for residential units situated above retail space.
We've been systematically looking at that. How do we attract businesses, small businesses, restaurants, entrepreneurial businesses, boutiques along the commercial corridor? That's what the neighbors are looking for. That's what they've asked for.
So what is it about a car wash that doesn't fit into that?
Well, I think there's a couple things. One, it's not really servicing the neighbors.
The alderman also cites traffic congestion as a concern. He says more than 200 neighbors signed a petition asking that he deny the permit.
We got notice that the permit was on hold for a pending zoning change. And that just caught me by surprise.
DiGerardo says he never received notice of the pending changes, but the city maintains that notice was sent to the property owner.
On the charge.
Aldermanic privilege became a dirty word in Chicago politics after the Ed Burke scandal.
These practices have gone on for far too long.
Mayor Lori Lightfoot campaigned on promising to curtail the practice. Thompson says this is not an example of the maligned practice run amok. He says he's simply representing his ward.
It's not me. I'm the voice for my community, and my community has clearly spoken on what they're interested in. He can try to claim that it's an abuse of aldermanic prerogative, which it's not. It's what my community wants, as evidenced by the petition I showed you that has over 200 names on it.
If you look at any of our other sites, you can
see. But DiGerardo says he believes he's being singled out. This is only happening on this one strip, right? Not all around.
That's right. That's right. He hasn't proposed any zoning changes next to me, down the street, anywhere around. He's targeted my property.
But Alderman Thompson says the man whose business is to make cars clean is actually the one playing dirty.
Oh, he tried to play dirty politics. He's tried to contact every law firm and every lobbyist that I know, thinking that that's going to influence me over my constituents. That's dirty. Doesn't happen in the 11th Ward. We don't do that. So
we're going to listen. And the zoning change has been approved by the committee. It will be voted on tomorrow by the full city council and is expected to pass, meaning DiGerardo likely only has two options, to either sell or to sue.
Has he told you which one of those options he's likely to take, or?
We asked him that directly, yeah. And he says he doesn't know what he's going to do. Okay. He'll make that decision after the council ultimately decides tomorrow. But as we said, it's likely to pass, and he's likely to be stuck with this land without being able to put a car wash there.
Okay. Thanks, Mike. Thank you.